Oh. Man.
Blender. Again.
Jeez. Hey, you know what? You know what would be awesome?
What?
We could totally do game reviews, like, in your face. Like, those ones from Zero Punctuation and, GameSpot.
Yeah. We could tell people which games to buy and which games to ban, right?
Yeah, exactly. If only we had a camera. To our very first and very vibrant episode of Side of Sarcasm. I'm Kyle.
And I'm Brett. And today we're going to be taking advantage of this camera to talk about a few games that we believe should be brought to light.
Our first game that we'll be reviewing is Guitar Hero DS for the Nintendo DS.
And as a retro review, we're going to tackle a bygone era and bygone system in this type of review. We're going to take on everybody's favorite subliminal messaging game, Earthbound, for the Super Nintendo Entertainment System. But first, a word from our sponsors.
We have sponsors.
Tired of not being able to decide which game is good without having to spend an hour reading a boring review?
Yeah.
Then tune into Side of Sarcasm to get your good game reviews.
We're on sponsors?
What the? And now on to our first review, a re-review of Guitar Hero for the DS.
Guitar Hero, DS, I don't know, dude. I think that the Guitar Hero series should just stay on the the mainstream, you know, like PlayStation 2 and Xbox 360. I mean, how does that even work?
Well, they have this little thing you put into where the Game Boy Advance cartridges usually go. It's like an option slot, and then you put your hand on there, and you work four buttons.
Well, four buttons?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Like, they really expect you to slide your hand back and forth on the DS.
I don't know. It loses its touch after the guitar, you know? You want to just... I don't know.
It's pretty good if you're out and about and you don't really have access to it, though.
Well, I heard that when you activate Star Power, you scream at the DS.
Well, you can do that, but you can also tap the bar.
I mean, you look pretty stupid screaming into public like that.
You don't really have to scream at it. You can just blow into the microphone. You don't know that trick?
No, I've done that before. But, okay, well, what about the song set list?
Well, it's got about 25 songs from various artists, anywhere between Ozzy Osbourne, Kiss, Twisted Sister.
Oh, I love those guys, man. It's been a long time since I heard them. Well, what about the graphics? I mean, I had one look at them, and they just kind of look like a bunch of Lego shapes to me.
Well, when you think about it, if it's a handheld system, they're not going to have very high-end graphics. Pretty well lucky that Nintendo coughed up the N64 graphics for instead of something pretty bad, like poorly rendered N64 graphics on the Super Nintendo platform.
I guess so. It's Guitar Hero. It's not genius. It's not epic fail, but I don't know.
It's something for people to keep themselves busy with until, say, World Tour comes out, eh?
And now another word from our sponsor.
Better not be us again.
Hi, I'm a Matt. You can tell because I'm better dressed than him.
And I'm a nerdy fat guy, otherwise known as a PC.
No thinly disguised subliminal messages there.
Oh man, I don't feel too well. I must have a virus. There were over 100,000 viruses for PC last year.
Huh. Only for PC, not Macs.
Is that because Macs have better antivirus protection?
No, it's because they don't bother making viruses for us.
Wow. You guys don't even get negative attention.
Yeah.
That's sort of depressing.
I cry myself to sleep a lot.
Alright, and now it's time for our retro review, where we're going to be looking at games from the past, the 90s, 80s, stuff like that. And today, we're going to be looking at a really unappreciated gem, I think. It's called Earthbound, and it's for the Super Nintendo, for those of you that remember. Oh man, good times playing that game. The story is about a guy, well, a basic 12-year-old boy, who just climbs up a cliff, going to save his friend's little brother, and, well, his adventure starts there after Buzz comes out the fly, and Starman starts attacking. It's just crazy. Oh.
This game sounds really messed up already, but it's originated from Japan in that time, right?
Anything from Japan is messed up. Let me tell you, dude. Alright.
That's just a bit mean, isn't it? I mean, they have some good stuff.
Yeah, okay, I'll give that to them. But you gotta admit, though, this game was full of subliminal messaging you don't even know.
So, subliminal messaging? What do you mean?
Alright, well, I'll explain one part to you. There's this one part where the main character, Ness, eats a magic cookie, and it sends him off to Dreamland.
Is this a magic cookie or a magic cookie?
I don't know. Read the subliminal message for yourself.
Well, I'm guessing it's sort of like a drug trip, isn't it?
Well, more or less. They made it look like a kid's game, but it's not really a kid's game.
Yeah.
Anyway,
Let's move on to the make or break part of it. What's the combat system like?
Well, it's your basic RPG genre. So you're basically running up, you hit them, they hit you, and, well, you get four party members, and yeah, it's just pretty awesome. I mean, there's even a lazy part of the game.
Lazy?
Lazy. Alright, say you ever wanted to kill monsters for experience and you didn't want to have to bother just going into battles all the time?
Oh, yeah.
Well, Earthbound comes with a special feature where if you kill a weaker monster, it just basically battles it for you.
Like if you're way overpowered and it knows it's going to die, you just instantly get the win?
Yep. That's pretty much it. Basically, you just hit it with your bat and you're down.
What's the encounter system like? Is it like you're walking around and suddenly you're in a fight, or is it you can see them?
Well, it's not so much a random encounter. You can see them, but it's got your basic, if you approach them in the back, surprise encounter. Approach them from the front, it's your basic battle, and if they get you from the back, you're pretty much screwed. But, yeah, you can see them, and they all look ridiculous.
Well, yeah, it's Super Nintendo graphics, right?
Yeah, but you gotta admit, they look pretty cool. I mean, those backgrounds are pretty trippy. Oh, well. But, what can you expect? Super Nintendo game.
Yeah.
Looks great, plays great, feels great. I recommend it for all you guys that still have a Super Nintendo.
And can find it.
Yeah.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's our show for today.
Well, we hope you enjoyed our praising and bashing and other bashing of these games that we had today.
We hope that any aspiring gaming programmers that are seeing this decide to hang out the old-fashioned hat and try making some really good games.
And I think it's time to ask what you, all you viewers out there, think.
Guys, you can't hear them.
Right. Then right. What do you think?
Me?
Yeah.
Oh, well, you guys should have done a good game, like Halo, or Call of Duty, or Gears of War, or Medal of Honor, or Pokemon.
Ah!